I'd like to show you a new feature in ArcGIS Pro called Data Engineering, which gives you a snapshot look at the fields in the attribute table of a data set. So you can get kind of a quick look at the distribution and the summary statistics. So I'd like to work with some census data. I'm going to use ArcGIS Online. And let's search for the ACS county household income. How about that? And we definitely want boundaries. Here's the median. That one looks good. Okay. So as this adds here, this is interesting data because it comes in pyramided or stacked by scale. So that when we're zoomed at a certain level, it's going to show us, I guess, the appropriate aggregation unit. So here we're at the state level, and as we zoom in, it will switch. I'm having a hard time with my mouse right now. And apparently data drawing. So it switches to the county level automatically, and it shows you that. You can see this is faded a little bit, and this one's not. And if we kept zooming in, it would switch to a more granular census tract level. I would like to look at the county level at this point. So I'm just going to turn these two off. If you want to control that, you can go into the properties. And under the general tab, you can see there's an in beyond and an out beyond scales. And you can change these if you want to, just so that they don't turn on and off. Okay, let's get to the data engineering. So I showed you this before, that when you have a layer selected in your contents pane, it pops up some specific options for that data set. And if I go to data, we can go into data engineering. It opens this panel for us. So you can click and drag any fields that you want to over here. These are all the fields that you'd see in the attribute table. And it is all about median household income. So I'm not going to pull all these in. It'll just slow down the calculations. I am going to bring in the one that's being displayed here, and I'm going to look and see if there's just like a number of households just for fun. Okay, so I'm selecting those two, and I'm going to just drag them over here. And then we ask it to calculate. So it's calculating all of the summary statistics, and it's going to show us a little thumbnail of the distribution of the values found in these fields. All right, when the calculations are done, it auto-populates here. You can see, you know, the chart preview. These are the histograms showing the distribution of the values in the field. And then we've got the min, max, mean, standard deviation, median. So all of the summary statistics are there. So if we look at the mean and the median, we can see that they are both around $56,000, which kind of makes me curious about the use of the divergent color ramp over here in symbolizing this data. A divergent color ramp implies that there's a neutral value or a pivot point value. And as we move away from that value, we're going to increase in intensity and color two different directions. So to use a divergent color ramp to display a continuous range of data is a little bit misleading, in my humble opinion. So I think I'd like to test that. But knowing that the median of the medians was around 56,000, that is not in the middle of, right? It's not the average of these two numbers. So I'm a little bit curious about that. Let's look at the symbology. When we're dealing with vector data, what we'd want to do here is, instead of unclassed colors, let's graduate it and use the standard deviation method instead of just regular breaks. Remember that whenever you change your symbology, it changes the field that we're drawing from, so we need to always double check this. And we want to go back to the original data set. And then let's get a divergent color ramp in here. And if you don't see those, make sure you have show all checked. All right, let's see here. I definitely want to use something that has green because green is dollars. So we could use green and pink, but let's just go back to this guy. Okay, so our low value is 16,000. That's the upper value for our lowest class. And then our upper max value is 156,800. So our middle right here, and also, yep, our high value is being displayed with green, but our middle, our zero, is falling in this class right here. The upper value is 65,000, and it's spanning that middle, this middle class is spanning from 49,000 up to 65,500. And so our mean slash median of $56,000 is sitting nicely right in between these. So I do feel like we are displaying this data more honestly than it was before. We can change our standard deviations to a half to get more texture in here to kind of show more detail. It doesn't mean that it's easier for people to differentiate between these colors, but it'll give the map a little bit more graduation, I guess. And comparing this to what we had, this is a very different looking map than the one that we had seen before. So at this, with this kind of display, now we know that the green states are above the national average for median household income, and the purple counties, I should say, are below the national average. And the darker the color gets, the farther you are away from the mean. All right, so that's data engineering and getting a quick look at your distribution of values and a tangent on divergent color ramps.